you.
The New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio is now calling for our Congress to permanently renew the law that gives medical care to 9/11 first responders. It's called the Zadroga Act. It's named for the New York police detective James Zadroga. He died of a respiratory disease after working at Ground Zero after the attacks of 9/11. We reported last month that the Zadroga Act expired after Congress, for various reasons, failed to renew it. The fund will not run out of money until next year, but then, well, it does. And the mayor says renewing it shouldn't really be a political issue at all.
It's not a red issue. It's not a blue issue. This is truly a red, white, and blue issue. There's no two ways about it. This is a question of patriotism. Are we going to serve those who responded after an attack on our nation? The answer must be yes, and it must be permanent.
So how big a deal is this? How many people are sick? Well, the feds say an estimated 33,000 people have gotten sick directly from breathing in the poisonous dust after the towers collapsed. 33,000. Just last week, the NYPD Lieutenant Marcy Sums died of lung cancer. She was 51. In a recent interview, Lieutenant Sims said the air at Ground Zero after 9/11 felt like it was, quote, burning your throat. Rick Leventhal was there, and it did. Supporters say this isn't just a New York City issue. They're victims of this, what, all over the country?
Because they were coming from all over the country to help out. People are getting treatment in all 50 states for respiratory illnesses and for cancer and other health issues connected to their work on that toxic pile in the weeks and months after 9/11. Supporters of the Zadroga Act say in addition to those 33,000 you mentioned, tens of thousands more could still develop serious health issues. And they point out the New York City police officers, more of them have died since 9/11 than died on 9/11 because of the dangerous materials that they inhaled. And now the clock is ticking on the benefits. Senator Kirsten Gillibrand says allowing this bill to expire was a moral outrage.
We asked them to come to 9/11, to the disaster site. We asked them to stay, to look for survivors, to find remains, to do the cleanup. And we told them the air was safe. And now they are dying of horrible cancers.
And if the Zadroga Act isn't reauthorized, she says more people will absolutely die.
Where's the shame and what's the holdup?
Well, many are blaming this Republican congressman from Virginia, Bob Goodblatt, who introduced a competing bill that's been described as a watered-down version, also with a five-year time limit and less compensation for the victims. That's why New York City Mayor de Blasio was on the steps of City Hall today with other congressional leaders to call on the leadership in Congress to get rid of that other bill and permanently reauthorize the Zadroga Act.
Never forget is more than a slogan, more than a bumper sticker. It is a sacred promise to take care of those who risk their lives to take care of us.
Congresswoman Maloney says if this bill went to Congress tomorrow, it would pass with bipartisan support, by the way. So the idea now is to pressure leadership to make that happen.
And Senator Gillibrand says give your congressperson a call.
Yeah, call them, email them, flood their inbox.
Let them know how you feel.
Yeah.
Thank you, Ricky. It's nice to see you.
You too.